A health reform advocate, meanwhile, calls on the Philippine government and the public to deal with the threat of pertussis seriously. Dr. Tony Liatron says a national immunization strategy is needed against the disease, and infants and children should be prioritized. He adds government should act fast to control the situation.
Mobility is not actually curtailed. So maybe the plateauing may be secondary to underestimation or underreporting. We might not be able to the true picture, but it's a relief for me if the numbers are plateauing. But we must prepare for escalation in other areas like Calabarzon because of its proximity to NCR and of course to South Luzon and of course to Central Luzon and also to tourist destination areas.
Iloilo City declares a pertussis outbreak following an uptick in confirmed cases. Rafael Bosano reports.
Iloilo City is the latest city to declare an outbreak of pertussis in the Philippines after logging 15 confirmed cases and 8 others suspected for the illness.
After the declaration, may amount to kami na aprobahan, no total of 16 million. A big portion will go to medicines and vaccines para makadugang kita. And if necessary, we will add more funds.
Prior to Iloilo City, Quezon City and Metro Manila also declared a pertussis outbreak. 111 cases have been logged in the capital region in the first 12 weeks of 2024 alone, much higher compared to the 5-year average prior to the pandemic. Pertussis is a bacterial infection which causes runny nose, fever, and cough. The cough can be bad enough to cause a person to gasp for air, causing a whooping sound. Like many illnesses that usually affect children, severe forms of pertussis can be avoided through a vaccine. But Metro Manila Council Chair and San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora says an intensified information campaign is necessary.
What we really have to do is inform the public, ano ba itong pertussis? Kahit ako po, aminado po ako na nitong mga nakarang araw, tsaka ko lang nalaman ano ba itong sakit na ito. Kaya mahalaga po talaga na magkaroon tayo ng massive information campaign sa lahat ng local government units.
The Philippine Health Department says to prevent respiratory diseases, it would be wise to wear a face mask. It adds a person manifesting symptoms of infection should be checked by a doctor right away.
Huwag muna po hanggang hindi na check up mabuti kasi meron po tayong tamang antibiotic para sa pertussis. Hindi po lahat ng antibiotics ay po pwede sa pertussis. Huwag na po natin pagtagalin, baka pagsisihan natin.
Health Undersecretary Eric Tayag says health centers will remain open despite the Holy Week break to provide vaccines to children who need them.
Konting sakripisyo para nang sa ganon ay consider po nila yan kasi hinahabol natin yung oras po sapagkat talagang nakakahawa yung tospirina at kung meron pa kayong mga bakuna na maring ibigay, ibigay na po ninyo. At kami naman sa Kagawaran ng Kalusugan ay inahabol namin para nang sa ganon, yung mga kulang na bakuna po ninyo ay ma-deliver na po namin.
After the COVID-19 pandemic, experts say it's now time to increase awareness on other diseases to avoid contracting them. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
A Philippine senator seeking a probe on the alleged links of Bambantarlac Mayor Alice Guo to illegal POGO operations. Senator Sherwin Gachalian says they found several documents linking Guo to Hongsheng Gaming Technology, including an application for a license bearing her name when she was not yet in office. The company reportedly changed its name to Zun Yuan Technology after it was raided by authorities last year over complaints of human trafficking and serious illegal detention. Another raid was conducted on the same compound earlier this month, where they found a billing statement under Guo's name. During the March raid, nearly 900 POGO workers were rescued, including over 400 Chinese nationals.
sa mga nakuha naming information at nakuha naming dokumento, may kinalaman yung current mayor ng Bamban dito sa Pogori dahil yung pangalan niya lumalabas sa maraming dokumento. Even nung bago pa na nagkaroon ng raid, even nung nag-a-apply pa lang ng dokumento itong kumpanyang ito.
Gatchalian also urged the Interior and Local Government Department to investigate Go's links to the illegal gaming industry. Now, Globe Telecom subscribers urged to exercise vigilance amid a surge in spoof messages designed to deceive people into divulging sensitive information. Globe said it received reports from customers who have fallen victim to deceptive text messages impersonating Globe's official sender ID. The scammers allegedly enticed recipients to click on dubious links, purportedly offering rewards, redemption opportunities. Malicious links, if clicked, could lead to the compromise of personal data, including sensitive financial information such as credit card details. Globe asserts it will never send an official advisory containing links. It also reminded customers that Globe rewards may only be claimed via the Globe One app. A heads up to the public, banks have announced their schedules for Holy Week this year. Take a look.